Honorable Chairman Nakasa, today's chair or moderator, Amarjit Chopra ji, my other two colleagues, Sanjay and Raju Sharan, sitting in the audience, Sharjah Shah, Finance Controller, Railways, Naresh Salecha, with my friend Atul Gupta, who has helped or assisted us in the Institute, ICA, in working in railways. Distinguished other officials of railways, members. Good afternoon to all of you. So in this today's technical session, accounting reforms in government, practitioners' needs and explanation, my area of talk is limited to partnering for governance through accounting. See, in any organization, governance is most important. In that, how accounting will make a role. So then, first of all, if you think, what is governance? Establishment of policies and continuous monitoring of their proper implementation by the members of the governing body of an organization. It includes the mechanism required to balance the powers of the members with the associated accountability and their primary duty of enhancing the prosperity and viability of the organization. That means accountancy should be with accountability. Accounting is a potential tool in the hands of the policy makers to have effective governance. Through proper accounting, one can keep track of the expenditures and income and establish an accurate picture of their overall financial data. Through accurate and thorough and correct accounting, beneficial decisions about investment, growth and operations can be taken. Accounting forms the basis of information which ultimately helps the decision makers and users of the information to draft new plans and take corrective action. Ultimately, accounting helps organizations to run smoothly on a practical, ethical and legal basis for continued growth, success and value addition. Such accounting will, particularly in coming in railways, the way the railways, Honorable Finance Minister Arun Jaitley said, we are having a competition from on road, the way the surface road constraints are going, the competition, or in the way the low-priced airlines is coming. So it is a required accounting properly. Then only a competitive price you can put. The way where the leakages are happening, the where the cost cut effects is then only it achieved. That's why what railways, rein, particularly in accounting, will railways will enable, rein in cost increase, escalation due to non-provision for capital commitments, provision for replacement of assets, some assets where it is not, suddenly will not last funds. So if you are having a proper planning, you can make a provision, which division where you require funds, you will be knowing well advance. Utilization of resources on priority basis. Suppose some program is there, some in building infrastructure is there, if you spend money, tomorrow for day-to-day running operations, money may not be there. The division again has to see that helm of the affairs. So utilization of resources definitely will help when you're having a proper management information system through accounting policies. Calculating real profit or loss. This is also most important. As Finance Minister said, different political sceneries will be there in the parliament. If everything is there, which state, how it has spent, how much money has gone. So the ministry will be in a capable to position uniformly and justified will be as spend the money, all the citizens of the country, it will help because being a public organization. Cash flow of the organization so that for prompt decision it will be happens very easily. Coming to, if you consider the pilot study conducted at the Northwestern Zone Railways by our Institute of Chartered Accountants, ARF. See, particularly for information, Institute of Chartered Accountants, as it is, we are not taking, we are a regulatory body. We formed a company under Section 8, Accounting Research Foundation. Under this we are doing, that's why ICA ARF, so for clarity of somebody, ICA is not doing, ICA whole subsidy body, Accounting Research Foundation, we have taken up this work. Here particularly, if you see the fixed assets replacement, the pilot project reflect non-charging of depreciation of rupees 3,845 crores to fixed assets in Northwestern region. This one reason, 3,845 crores not charged. Enabled decision making for developing reserve funds out of the surplus before any other appropriation, thus reaching to stage of self-sufficiency in replacement of assets. Recognition of leased assets resulting in proper recording of assets and liabilities. Fixed assets records for valuation.
Around 63,000 fixed assets with NW are categorized into 17 classes according to their nature. Around 13,000 assets were taken at nominal value due to non-availability of data relating to cost, date of acquisition, etc., which includes around 3,200 numbers buildings, 1,700 numbers bridges and tunnels, 4,000 numbers plant, machinery and equipments. Needs to develop strategy for maintaining record for date of acquisition, cost. These assets may have large amount of valuation and can support in overall evaluation of net worth of Indian Railways asset base. Capital work in progress of rupees 2,102 crores identified and disclosed separately. Other assets, contingent liability in respect of passenger claims, commercial claim and compensation claim identified amounting to rupees 35,000 crores. Capital commitments, net advances, 11,215 crores was arrived, which can be used for decision making for fund management. Actual valuation of employees liability. As per actual analysis of NWR zone, liability on these heads comes to 28,253 crore, which is more than the net worth of NWR zone. Accrual accounting will assist in policy formulation like costing of services and decision making. Preparation of significant accounting policies and notes to accounts for better understanding of financial statements. India is now an isolated country. World has become a small village. If you see some ideas happen in Japan, production or effective is happening in India and China, marketing may be in a European country, end user Africa, South Africa. The way it has gone, the way the governments are taking different activities, the accounting policies are most important. Internationally now IFAC, SAFA, CAPA, they are setting a lot of accounting standards. That ICA is taking and we are making an ARF. That also, that class information, whatever research is there, we are importing in these accounting standards in policies at the also. Take away from pilot study, outstanding receivables and payables. In the existing system, there is a provision to record outstanding receivables and payables through demand recoverable and demand payable. However, demand payable is operated to record outstanding salary only in northwestern region only. Areas of accrual impact. There were around 60 areas identified where impact of accrual was perceived, which are hitherto not shown as current assets and current liabilities. Formats for capturing data about these actual impact areas have also been devised. Once data is captured in these formats, it will form part of the current assets and current liabilities in the balance sheet. Some of these areas of accrual impact are as under: work measurement done but bill not received, bill received but payment not made, revenue received but service not provided, employees liabilities versus pension, demands payable, salary payable. Based on matching principle, advance earnings estimated at rupees 105 crores. Outstanding liabilities are identified amounting 32 crores for the year ended 31st March 2015. So this is just a cursory, whatever the statistics which we got. Now what is public accountability? Organizations are accountable to various stakeholders including public in a variety of ways. Proper accounting helps them meet their obligations to various stakeholders. It may be state government, central ministers, different corporations, many suppliers, whoever is there, separate other governments which are coming, even world organizations, to strengthen. Tomorrow we don't know how railways may take different projects in foreign countries, African countries. So to strengthen this public accountability, how we are doing transparency, it helps. Stakeholders and accountability. Organizations are largely required to give shareholders financial statements containing detailed financial information. Financial statements allow stakeholders the information to make better informed decisions. Particularly here, Parliament, all MPs, wherever it is, state government, chief ministers. Once it is there, the ministry, finance ministry, prime minister, everybody feel comfort and it makes a good beginning. Cash flows, ultimately the cash flows only makes a decision. Accounting aids long-term planning and is also vital for making short-term decisions. Accounting helps lenders manage money, prioritize and take concrete financial action. Accounting also supports organizations in planning and for better debt management, where you have to raise funds, where you have to advance, everything. Starting from employees, housing loans also, where, how much budget you can allocate, everything we can do. In order to realize good governance, the government is expected to perform various measures to improve transparency and public accountability. One of them is implementation of double accounting system, not accrual system. Double accounting system already is there. We have to make very seriously this thing. Friends, one thing, those who are accustomed to this cash-based system, or you are not only cash-based system, you are double accounting, you feel whatever is there, transparent is appearing. So many 150 years has gone smoothly. Why they change? The way the world is changing, the way the expectations are happening, we have to adapt. See, the relevance is there adapting to the change. If you are not adapt to the change, you are nowhere there. Now if you see, in our younger age, we have seen the typewriters. Entire information used to go to the typewriter. Now to show your children, grandchildren, you have to take a photo and show the typewriter. See, now everything has a computer. So the way they think, one day will become a cool system is a part of their life. It maybe has to be established, and the secondary school also, primary schools also has to start. Somewhere foreign countries, I've seen somewhere, Brazil or somewhere, they started in the 10th class syllabus, also there is an accounting. See, we are a branch out of commerce intermediate level. So that's my sincere request, what we are doing, officials, maybe in the H, see, I'm 5 years, 6 years, my department is different. It may not be relevant. Let me go. The new immigrants come, you may think. My sincere request, involve, have a fashion. This may be helpful for you tomorrow in accounting. Same railways may be absorbed in different zones for you. But one thing, when you are doing this, you may feel difficult even. See, the computerization, when computerizations come, any organization or government has resisted. Now everybody will be comfortable with computerization. This is also a little bit difficult, and we are very happy. Atul used to bring to my notice, Atul Gupta, my council member. Initially, people has a little bit reservations. Then you have all railways, wherever we are doing an NWG or Kaputra project, people used to give a lot of information support to us. I am sure in the coming future, you are also involved, this definitely becomes. One thing which I want to remind, our tradition is very rich. If you follow Lord Krishna, one Gita, what he says, Bhagavad Gita, Sreyan Swadharmoganha, Swadharma Nidhanam Sreya, Paradharma Bhayavaha. The line which you have chosen, whatever difficult dog, don't leave it, pursue, you will get the results. Same way, in this organization which you have got, it may be difficult, you feel is irrelevant, don't bother. Do it, it is hour of the need. Definitely, you are going to help railways in turn to the government as a responsible citizen of India. After your retirement also in your organization or your individual capacity as a consultant, definitely this information will help you, and in turn again you can help the nature. With this, I congratulate particularly railway officials, the way they are taking, and last but not the least, my honest appreciation and regards to our Railway Minister Suresh Prabhuji for taking boldly this initiative to go forward. And definitely India is becoming 21st century. This contribution of railways has also become one addition value. Thank you, one and all.